Okay, hello. So the second method of depreciation is the units of production. We're going to do that. The units of production means we're going to calculate depreciation based on the usage of that asset. The more we use it, the more depreciation. The less we use it, the less depreciation. A perfect example for that is a car or a van. The more mileage you put on a truck or a car, that will be, we can calculate more depreciation. The less we use it, the less depreciation we can record. Machine for a factory, the more machine hours they use it, the more depreciation we can record, and the less. Yeah. So it's not like the straight line method where you do equal depreciation every year regardless of the usage. Okay, so the information that needs to be given to us in order to be able to calculate the depreciation year after year using the units of production is the historical value. So let's have an example here. So we have PDS company expects to drive a truck 20,000 miles the first year, 30,000 miles the second year, 25 the third year, and 50 in the fourth year, and 10,000 the fifth. So it does have a 5 years useful life, just like the previous example we had. We purchased it for $40,000 as well. We're not changing that fact. And the useful life, so that's 5 years. But I'm not just going to divide the 40,000 by five. We're gonna give different depreciation for every year, based on the miles. So we need to know how many miles every year, just like the information given to us here. And of course, we still need to know what was the salvage value or the residual value, which is $1,000, just like the previous example. So the first step is to calculate what is the cost per mile. That's the first step. And then the cost per mile, every year we're going to multiply it by the amount, the number of miles we used it in that year. Okay, that gives me the total depreciation for the year. So the cost per mile is the total depreciation over the 5 years divided by the total number of miles that we're going to use it over the 5 years. Okay, so the total divided by the total. Remember that, total divided by total. Total dollars divided by the total units. Dollar amount is always in the numerator. It's always up. Okay, so the historical value or the purchasing value was 41,000, and then we subtracted the residual value of 1,000, and we divided that by the total units. So if we look at the total units, it's 100,000. It's technically the 20 plus 30 plus 25 plus 15 plus 10. That is 100,000. So 40,000 divided by 100,000, that gives me 40 cents per mile. So the next step is easy. We just multiply 40 cents by the number of miles. So year one, this is how we calculated the 40 cents. Year one, we used it for 20,000 miles. 20,000 multiplied by 40 cents, that will give me $8,000 the first year. And then the second year, so here's the schedule again, the depreciation schedule, but this time using the units of production. The first year, 40 cents multiplied by 20 equals 8,000. And then the second year, 40 cents multiplied by 30,000 miles. That gives me 12,000. It's more than last year, okay? Third year, we multiply by 25,000, fourth by 15, and then 10. Every year, we got different amount of depreciation, okay? Now, recording the journal entry is exactly the same either we use the units of production method or depreciation, straight line method, it's the same. It's debit to depreciation expense and credit to accumulated depreciation. The only difference between the methods is how to calculate the amount, not how to record the journal entry. So accumulated depreciation, the year one is 8,000, and then year two we added the 12 plus the 8, that gives me 20, and then year three we're accumulating more and more and more and more. So 20 plus the 10, 30, 30 plus the 6, 36, 36 plus the 4, we came up with 40,000. Total depreciation over the 5 years is 40,000. And the original value was 41, so obviously the residual value will end up being $1,000 as well, just like the straight line method. The main difference is how we distributed the $40,000 depreciation over the 5 years. Did we distribute them equally, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, or we used a different method of calculation, which ended up being 8, and then 12, and then 10, and then 6, and then 4. The total is still 40,000, okay? Then book value, we discussed the book value in the previous video. You just subtract the accumulated depreciation from the original cost. That will give you the residual, the book value at some point. And then the book value at the end of year five should equal the residual value. Otherwise, there's something wrong in calculation. Okay, thank you.